Good evening. Thank you all for joining us here tonight. It is now my privilege to invite to the stage Sarah Jane Blackmore. Sarah is the daughter of Lieutenant James Blackmore, who made the ultimate sacrifice in the line of duty in 1998.
Thank you for that introduction, Lauren, and an even bigger thank you for putting together such an amazing event. I am so grateful to have been given the opportunity to be here tonight to speak about my father, Lieutenant James Blackmore of Engine 332. Woo-hoo! I see you, Bradford Street. Jimmy, as he was affectionately called, came from humble beginnings in Ozone Park, Queens, as one of 10 children. Yeah. He proudly served his country in the United States Marine Corps and worked as a Rockaway Beach lifeguard before finding his true calling as one of New York City's bravest. He married a Rockaway girl, naturally. My mother, Susan, and had four children, me, my two sisters, Jacqueline and Claire, and my brother, Brian. He was the dad on the block who looked out for the little kids playing in the street like a hawk in a lawn chair, making sure that cars weren't speeding along our dead-end block. He was everyone's protector, but also everyone's friend. He played with all the kids, shooting hoops, doing flips off the diving board at the community pool. It was little gestures like that that made a big difference in our lives. Sure, running into burning buildings and saving lives is pretty admirable, but sneaking the family dog into a Days Inn motel room during a family road trip on the way to Florida is a pretty freaking awesome to four kids under the age of 10, I'm just saying. And that's how I choose to remember him. My dad was crazy about his family. You'd think that those 24, 48 hour shifts at the firehouse would leave him incapacitated, but no. He still had time to help with homework, dinner, dishes, bedtime routines, and maybe, if he was lucky, he would catch a Seinfeld episode on Thursday nights. Who am I kidding? God help us if we were not in bed by 9 p.m. on Thursday nights. I still smile and think of him whenever I hear that electric bass solo of the Seinfeld theme music. Whenever a rerun is on, you know what I'm talking about. Yes, growing up in such a large household was chaotic and hectic and loud, sure, but that was our normal, and I was never lonely. All of that changed on June 5th, 1998, when I was just a few months shy of my 13th birthday. My father was tragically killed in a five-alarm blaze on Atlantic Avenue in Brooklyn. I remember the call from my Uncle Kevin to my mother. Turn on the news, I think Jimmy's been in an accident. But before we could get any information, there was a knock at the door. My mom peered through the glass, and I heard a scream that made my blood run cold. I rushed to see what sort of monstrous being could have caused my mom to scream like that. But to my surprise, under the dim glow of our front porch light, I was face to face with a priest. It was Father Delendik. The next few days were such a blur, an endless rotation of people and flowers and food, but mostly confusion and questions. So many unanswered questions. Questions I was afraid to ask. But nevertheless, they still weighed on me so heavily that some points it was hard to breathe. Why did he go back into the building? Did he suffer? How did the fire start in the first place? The list went on and on as I spiraled into myself, and I never felt so alone in my entire life. Life without my father in it seemed unthinkable. There was obviously my sadness from missing my dad, then my regret for not giving him one last hug before his final shift. Then there was my paranoia when I would obsessively check the locks and windows because I thought our house was now less safe for not having him in it. And then there was my shame for not feeling better after a time or for not feeling grateful to those who only wanted to help. And then there was my confusion from not knowing who to blame for how all of this happened. I didn't know it at the time, but this endless list of emotional pain I was trying so hard to ignore all stemmed from fear. And the scary thing about fear is that when it goes unchecked, it can manifest into something much more scarier. Anger. And God, I was angry. And I had a long journey of healing ahead of me, a journey that would probably last my entire life. However, because of the help I received through the assistance of Answer the Call, I can stand in front of you all and say that I have accepted that bittersweet fate. I can say it out loud. My grief for my father will never vanish entirely. But you know what? I don't think I want it to. It took a long time and a lot of therapy to reach that realization and then accept it. But I eventually got there. I was lucky enough for organizations like Answer the Call to assist with providing financial assistance so that I could seek the treatment that would provide me with the emotional foundation that would allow me to face my fear and anxieties head on and learn to use those techniques that would help me to manage my pain and continue to do so to this very day. Answer the Call also provided some temporary escapes. The kind that helps you to put that grief on the back burner, even just for an afternoon. Those little escapes like Mets games and Christmas parties and Empire State Building lightings. They taught me how to enjoy life again, bit by bit. Answer the Call taught me that I could participate in life and still honor my father. Tonight, I'd like to say thank you to all the helpers in the room, including the memory of Rusty Staub. Thank you for helping us to pick up the pieces. Thank you for helping our family to maintain some semblance of normalcy and routine that is so crucial in the grieving process. And most importantly, thank you for helping us to honor and remember my father, Lieutenant James Blackmore, and his sacrifice. And thank you for answering the call.
Thank you so much, Sarah. You mentioned that before your dad became a firefighter, he was a lifeguard in Rockaway Beach. Woo. And yeah, for Rockaway. To commemorate his service, a bench will be dedicated in memory of your father in Rockaway Beach.
Oh,
and we actually had a special guest who really wanted to be here with us tonight to help me make that announcement, but unfortunately, he wasn't able to join us. That special guest was Jerry Seinfeld. He was so honored to hear that your dad was a fan and chose to spend his Thursday nights with him. And so since he couldn't be here, he wanted me to invite you to his upcoming show and to have you come backstage and meet him so that he can thank you for your father's service.
Thank you so much. Thank you.